Welcome to New Hampshire's Business. I'm Fred Kocher. With the $2 trillion White House infrastructure plan about ready to go through the legislative journey, we here in New Hampshire's Business are going to focus on New Hampshire's infrastructure needs. And we did so in the 640 segment this morning, where we looked at job roads and bridges and airports. And now we're going to look at other needs in this segment. And with me to do that is the economist, Dr. Karen Spohn, who was also associate professor of business and finance in the Division of Business and Security Studies at Rivier University in Nashua. Welcome back.
Thank you, Fred.
Before we go to the list of New Hampshire's infrastructure needs, Karen, you've gone through the White House infrastructure plan with a fine-tooth comb. We usually think of infrastructure as roads, bridges, airports, but that definition appears to have changed. So now we include things such as broadband, dams, and wastewater.
Yes, that's true. Like anything else, infrastructure changes, and it changes for two reasons. Technology can change. For example, driverless cars, they will not become a part of our future unless broadband is spread 100% and it is affordable and accessible to everyone. The other thing that changes infrastructure needs are external shocks, and we've experienced one recently with COVID. COVID has caused a structural change in our economy in such a short time that usually takes a longer period, and it's changed the demand of individuals to work at home remotely, for students to study at home remotely, yep. And that has changed things.
Well, you mentioned broadband. Here is a list of some more infrastructure needs in New Hampshire. One of them is broadband. Unacceptable speeds in 5% of the state. In broadband, one internet provider in 62.7% of New Hampshire and none in 10% of New Hampshire. And then also Superfund and Brownfield sites. Remediation and development of those sites. There are 22 in New Hampshire. It's worth noting that Karen and I are looking at infrastructure needs of New Hampshire based on the information and facts that we can find and get our hands on. Now, here's some more of those needs. Dams, 151 high-hazard dams in the state. Wastewater, $2 billion in wastewater needs in New Hampshire. Electric grid, 278 outages, 2008 to 2017 and more since. And schools, a $324 million gap in estimated school capital expenditures. And you can see the sources right below there. Karen, the electric grid is certainly in need of an upgrade in our schools as well, but we don't often hear about dams and wastewater, usually forgotten.
That's right. Dams are an important piece of our economy as a water supply. It supports our lake regions. And if something would happen that they would fail, the surrounding area could suffer major damages from that. The other one, wastewater, is also key. A lot of the septic and sites, public and private, are aging, and those things need to be replaced. Resilience against harsh weather is really important in those types of areas because flooding can cause public health
issues. And we have had harsh weather events in this state, as you know. As an economist, before we go, I have to ask you briefly, what's your opinion on the Biden administration's plan to pay for all of this? With the higher taxes on the wealthy and on businesses that don't pay tax.
The paying of infrastructure is the hardest part. What Biden's proposal has presented is a corporate tax increase from 21 to 28%. And that would be on businesses because businesses use and benefit from a lot of the infrastructure. But that it also raises businesses' cost. And so that could have some slower indications on economic growth if that would feed through employment and wage changes. But user fees are also offered as a possible tax policy. If you cross the bridge, then you pay for it. But those tend to fall at a greater proportion on lower income individuals. So it's not an easy question. Some other ideas have been floated, and it'll be interesting to see.
Karen, my thanks to economist Dr. Karen Spohn, who also teaches business and finance at Rivier University in Nashua. She and I are going to continue to look at New Hampshire's infrastructure needs, and a lot of them in the plan we have not addressed yet, but we're still looking for that information. and such as manufacturing, clean energy, caregiving, and so forth.